coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Should be a good one here this afternoon between the Washington Nationals and the Houston Astros. The speedy Trey Turner digs in now, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. Swing and a soft liner, and he'll have himself a leadoff single as this is through into left.
Batting seven, the center fielder, number two.
In now, Adam Eaton. One and two now to Adam Eaton. Now a ground ball for Altuve, could be two. To second for one, to Gurriel, and they get them both. So bases are empty here with two gone. And stepping in is the second baseman, Howie Kendrick. Kendrick waiting, now the pitch. Here's a shot to left field and deep. It's up and out of here into the archways. Into the box now, Juan Soto. And a changeup couldn't get him to bite, and it's ball four. So it's a runner at first with two gone. And in steps the lefty power threat, Eric Thames. The 2-1 fouled off. The 2-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Working for the punch out and the offering. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field.
Batting fifth. The catcher, number 20.
To the plate now, Kurt Suzuki. Mm-hmm. Still even at 2-2. And it's fouled away. The 2-2 pitch. A bouncer to the left side. Throw to first in time, and the big inning is avoided as the side is retired. And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Here comes the 2-1 to Brantley.
I got 3-1. Three balls, one strike.
This is hit the other way out toward left field. Soto comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. And that'll bring up the former first rounder Alex Bregman. His career batting line with Patrick Corbin. He's 0 for 4. Right side. Oh, and he can't come up with it. And the recovery's too late as he's able to beat the throw to first. Runner at first following the error. And that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Jose Altuve. Now the 1-1 pitch. He sends it out to left field. Well hit. And that is just shy of the box seats, off the top of the wall. Throw won't get him.
Batting fourth, the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez.
Into the box, Yordan Alvarez. I had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2.
Hey, I can't have one of my best left-handed power bats fishing for balls off the plate.
And the pitch is off the catcher's glove as it rolls away. So the lead runner holds on, but the trailer will take second. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
The shortstop, Carlos Correa.
line toward right center. And that's in there. Base hit. To second now, but he's safe as they take the lead with two runs scoring on the play.
Batting fifth, the center fielder, Joel Springer.
At the plate now, George Springer. And he connects with it. This one's hit deep out to left center field. And, oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. At the plate, Josh Reddick. Fouled away. Three runs already home here. Grounded to short. Turner fields it cleanly. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. So here's Starlin Castro. This ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. Little chopper back to the mound. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. Stepping into the box, Asdrubal Cabrera, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
Well, if you're looking for pop, he definitely has more pop. More home run potential hitting from the left side. This is his power side.
To two balls and two strikes now. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. Three and two now. Due next, there's Ryan Zimmerman. Grounded down the third baseline. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Neither guy giving in. Here's the next one. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work. Here's Ryan Zimmerman now. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. The 1-2. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. Here now is Trey Turner. He singled to open up the ballgame.
Not an easy thing to do when you're in the leadoff spot, but that was a good piece of hitting in his first at bat, an opposite field base.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Striding in for Houston, Yuli Gurriel. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out. So one away here with the bases empty. And up next, the former Angel Martin Maldonado. And there's ball three on a breaking ball that misses away.
He might still be thrown off from that first inning, guys. He got knocked around pretty good, and that can be hard to recover from mentally sometimes.
3-2 now. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. So it's back to the top of the order now, and Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. Now the 1-1 pitch. This is hit the other way out toward left field. And he dives to make a spectacular catch. What a play there to end the inning. Striding in once again, Adam Eaton, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. And they won't have a play as he reaches it first. Let's see how this is scored.
Now back. Second baseman. Howie.
Stepping in now, Howie Kendrick. Softly hit down to third, likely no shot at two. On to first, and they get the double play, but boy, was he ever upended at second base. So base is empty now after the double play. And next to bat will be the outfielder, Juan Soto. Line shot to third, and the side is retired. Bottom of the third now, and that'll bring up Alex Bregman. Reached on an error and then eventually scored in his first at-bat. Now a swing by Bregman and a ball hit well to deep left. Into the Crawford boxes and gone. In now, Jose Altuve. Two balls and a strike to Jose Altuve.
Looks like that bomb earlier in the inning kind of put this pitcher on the defensive. That being very aggressive right now.
There's strike two as the hanging slider was let go. Fastball is outside and it's full now, 3-2. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
Now batter.
So here's the Astros cleanup hitter, Yordan Alvarez. 0-for-1 here in the early going. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. The 2-2. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Next to the Astros.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And the former number one overall pick in American League Rookie of the Year, Carlos Correa, bats next. And a fastball misses there, ball four.
Now batting, center fielder, Joel Springer.
The 1-1. Hard on the ground towards short. And that's through for another base hit. He'll make it 2-for-2 in this one. To the plate now, Josh Reddick. And a slider's in for a strike. It's 2-2.
Wow, not sure what they're looking for right there, but that one was pretty much middle center cut. Tough pitch to take.
And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. Stepping in, Eric Thames. He singled his last time up. Now the 1-1 pitch. Is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
1-2.
Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
I know he buried that slider in right there, but that's a dangerous pitch. If he doesn't pop commit and bury that inside, it leaks out over the plate. He can get hurt with that pitch.
Throw to first in time, one gone here in the fourth.
Number 28.
So the base is empty here with one away, and that'll bring in the catcher, Kurt Suzuki. Good swing just a little early, and he'll see another payoff pitch. Holds off on the slider, and that's a good idea as it's ball four. Here's Starlin Castro. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Strike taken as that one catches the outer part of the plate. This is on the ground over to first. Gurriel scoops it up. The second for one. Onto the pitcher covering, and it's in time. A double play, and the inning is over. So here's Yuli Gurriel. To 2-2 now.
Well, it's been a rough one so far. Four runs through three innings. It's about time to get that pitch count down, or he won't be out here very long.
And this is swung on and missed, and this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third, with a strikeout. And there's one away. The 1-1.
Too high.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind you.
And that'll get down for a base hit.
Now back, left fielder, Michael Brantley.
Into the box now, Michael Brantley. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with only one away. So coming to the plate, Alex Bregman. He's 1-for-2 in this one. The 2-2 will not catch the zone, ball three.
Well, the 1-2 pitch didn't go his way, and now a miss there on 2-2. You know he doesn't want this at bat to get away from, so I think we're going to see a challenge pitch on a full count.
Line toward right center, and a dive, but it rattles in and out of the glove. And they will hold that runner over at third as he'll move up only 90 feet, but the bases are loaded with one away. Eric Fetty was called upon to pitch, really needing that double play ball. Bases are loaded here with only one man out. Standing in now, Jose Altuve. And a curveball here. Good pitch, but a better take, and it's to 2-1 now. Swings through it for strike number two. Working for the punch out and the offering. A bouncer up the middle. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. Notch one in the score column as the runner from third crosses the plate. And it's not in time. He's safe. As also on the play, a run comes across to score.
Alvarez.
The 3-1 pitch. On the ground to Kendrick. This might be two. One there. Relay to Zimmerman. The double play to end the inning. All set for the start of the inning. Into the box now as Drubel Cabrera. He drew a walk his first time up. 2-1 pitch is a fastball. Swung on and missed. 2-2. And that's taken high for a ball. It's full now, 3-2.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
The first baseman.
At the plate, Ryan Zimmerman. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 1-1 is strike two swinging.
So far in this game, he's the only guy in the lineup that's gone down on strikes.
This is the only guy in the lineup that struck out so far, and now he finds himself in the hole with two strikes.
Return throw is in time, and what do you know, they do get the double play. Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up one of the fastest players in all the land, Trey Turner. Now the 1-1 pitch. Line to the right side. He lays out for it, but he can't win. And this one bounds around against the wall. And he is into third with a two-out triple.
The center fielder, number two, Adam Eaton.
Into the box, Adam Eaton. Full count now, 3-2. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four. Rogelio Armenteros trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away. Howie Kendrick will be the first one to greet him now as he'll do so with runners at the corners and two out in the inning. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to one and two now. Looking to wiggle out of this, here it is. Hit on the ground to third, and the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Digging in once again, Carlos Correa. It was a walk in his last trip. Now a curveball here, nowhere close. That's in the dirt. It's 3-1.
They know the threat this guy possesses at the plate. I know it's 3-1 in this situation right here, but I can't imagine anything comes over the heart of the plate.
And that misses ball four now. It's a leadoff walk to get the home half of the fifth underway. Here's George Springer. And if you remember, he took home a Silver Slugger Award for AL outfielders a year ago. Now here's a check swing, and they appeal down to first. No swing. So that's ball four. Next up for the Astros, Josh Reddick. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. Reddick waiting, and now the pitch.
This is the kind of pitching that's frustrating for me to watch. He had him down 0-2, then he started getting cute, and now the count is full at 3-2. It happens, but I...
He pulls this one high and deep to right center field. Gets the call to pitch here, and he'll try to sort this mess out. He's going to try to at least eat a couple of innings for his guys. At the plate, Yuli Gurriel. Count is 1-2 now. Bramer, a native of Louisiana, the Bayou State. He was taken in the 18th round back in the 2016 first-year player draft.
Hey, this guy's got a chance to be an absolute steal. Being drafted where he was, there are definite signs that he has a chance to make an impact at the big league level.
Ready for another shot now, Martin Maldonado. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Down low, two balls and a strike. Eight runs, eight hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. A 2-2 count to the Astros catcher. Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
Action pitch right here, 2-2. Last thing you want to do is to fall behind the count 3-2.
So it was a strikeout swinging. Martin Maldonado becomes the second out in the bottom of the fifth. Pulled toward right center field. Legs churning. He's headed for second. And this one bounds around against the wall. And they'll keep it going here as he's into third base with a triple.
Third baseman number two, Allen.
In now, Alex Bregman. Fastball is looked at for strike two.
A pretty aggressive pitch right there up in the zone. Surprised he didn't offer at it.
Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
Lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball. And another foul ball. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Soto is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. New inning set to get underway. Here now is Juan Soto. Hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line out.
Yeah, Maddie, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive.
There's a swing and a ball hit in the air, and a ball that he got every stitch of, as that one, without a doubt, is gone. To the plate now, Eric Thames. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1. Good time to call the change as he swings and misses for strike two.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
And the throw on to first will take care of him, so he's thrown out by the only man standing on the left side of the infield. One away.
The catcher, number 28.
So digging in now, Kurt Suzuki. It was a walk in his last trip. Now the 1-1 pitch is looked at off the plate for a ball. Two and two the count. Now the pitch.
We got full count.
There's Starlin Castro. He'll follow next. And he fouls this one off. Payoff pitch one more time. Hit on the ground out to short. On to first, and Suzuki's retired. Two away. Striding forward now is the DH. Starlin Castro, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Will Crow gets the call to pitch here, and he'll try to sort this mess out. He's going to try to at least eat a couple of innings for his guys. Now at the plate, Jose Altuve. He was able to reach base thanks to an error in his last at-bat. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Count even at 2-2. Here it comes.
3-2.
And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
The batter, number 44.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Yordan Alvarez. No thump out of him in this game so far, as might be expected. He's 0-for-3. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball.
Wow, from 0-2 to 3-2, and that last pitch on 2-2 wasn't even close. He had this guy in the road.
There's a swing and a high drive into left center field, but it bangs off the out-of-town scoreboard. And they've really got something going here. Runners at second and third to start the inning.
The batter,
into the box now, Carlos Correa. The count now at 2-2. From the belt, the pitch. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. But that'll ricochet off the facade out there in left center. Throw to second, but he's in there as two runs come across to score away from the play.
The center fielder, number four.
Plate now, George Springer. And this is swung on and missed, and boy, they took care of a key man there. One away. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Hit hard to short. Throw on to first, two gone. Now the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. Runner in scoring position with two gone.
Yuli up key.
The 3-1 pitch, and that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out. Now batting, Martin Maldonado. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one, and we'll see if he tries to.
Well, the play's been made, and that retires the side. Chris Devinsky is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 47.
Now in the box, Asdrubal Cabrera. It was a walk in his last trip.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
One ball and two strikes to count. And he'll hang in here as he reaches to foul this one away.
Hey, last two pitches back to back off speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
There is Altuve, and the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. Striding in now for the Nats, Ryan Zimmerman. He struck out and bounced into a double play in his first two at bats. Good battle, count remains full. The 3-2 one more time. Popped him up. And he'll squeeze this one for the second out. Victor Robles will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the base is empty.
Victor Robles.
Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1. Can't connect there. It's 2-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Gurriel has it, and the side is retired.
For the traditional seventh inning
Daniel Hudson comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one.
Daniel Hudson.
Aledmys Diaz is up off the bench as he'll be asked to get something started in the home half of the seventh. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Looked like he swung at ball four right there. Clearly he saw something in that pitch that he liked out of the pitcher's hand, but that wasn't a pitch he was going to do a whole lot with.
And that's going to be a base hit, so a great job off the bench as he's aboard to kick off their half of the inning. Kyle Tucker will come on to pinch hit now with a runner at first and nobody out. Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1. Jose Altuve waits on deck. Fastball is taken for a strike, and he runs it full, 3-2.
Sometimes you can get away with a pitch in that location when you're running it up there that hard, but not consistently. You still have to work the edges of the zone most of the time.
So he gets the swinging strikeout on the changeup. Kyle Tucker is dealt with for the first out in the bottom of the inning. Full count still. Diaz leads off first with one away. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. Ronnie Dawson will look for some two-out magic here as he'll pinch hit with two gone and a runner at first. Outside, 2-1. High fly ball out to straightaway center. After it is eaten. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. CNL Perez has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 52.
Andrew Stevenson is going to be asked to get things going here as a lead off the top of the eighth. Line drive to center field. And the pinch hitter is retired here, one away. Yan Gomes will move into the on deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
Little hesitation right there by the batter. It was great execution by the pitcher down and away. But that looked like a late swing. Could have been sitting on something else.
Grounded to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Michael Taylor will get a shot here as a pinch hitter.
Number three, Michael A. Taylor.
It's 1-2.
I got to count 1-2.
Goes down and gets it as this is bounced to short. A dive and he knocks it down. And not really much of a chance to recover there as he'll reach first on what undoubtedly will be scored as an infield single. Stepping in now, Eric Thames. And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. Line towards center field. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. So now they'll have runners on the corners with two away. Jake Knoll. See what he can do off the bench as he'll bat with runners at the corners and two gone here.
Jake Knoll.
Two runs, eight hits, and three errors for these guys so far this afternoon. And a fastball called strike three, and the side is retired. Wander Suero enters now in a mop-up role as he'll try to keep the deficit right where it is.
Wander Suero.
Taylor Jones is going to grab a bat here as he looks to try to set the table in the bottom of the eighth as they look for some insurance. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. He extends nicely, and this ball's driven to right field and deep. A leap, but he can't bring it back into the park. It's a home run. James Ritchie will come on as a pinch hitter.
Now batting, the center fielder, James Ritchie.
Hit to first. Zimmerman has it, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Into the box now, Josh Reddick. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Reddick behind a ball and two strikes. little roller toward the hole. Scooped up. And they'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. Standing in, Yuli Gurriel. It was a walk in his last trip. Here's the 2-1. And this pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play, so the count goes to 2-2 now. And now a pitch on the way. Ani pops it up. Cabrera just to the left of the mound, and that's the third out. Brad Peacock comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Number 41, Brad Peacock.
To the plate now is the designated hitter, Starlin Castro. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. There's strike two on a fastball right down the middle. And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth. At the plate, Asdrubal Cabrera. He was a ground-out victim last time up. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. High in the air out to center field. Ferguson will settle under it to make the play for the first out, as the runner will have to head back to first. Now at the plate, Ryan Zimmerman. In his last at bat, he popped out in foul ground.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop-up foul.
Two balls and two strikes, the count to Ryan Zimmerman. Here's the pitch on 2-2. And solid contact there as this ball is belted high in the air out to left. Not quite out of here. It's off the out-of-town scoreboard. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one-out double.
The batter, number one, shortstop Wilmer Defoe.
Into the box, Wilmer Defoe. And he misses with it, ball four. So that'll load the bases, and now he's now really going to need to get a ground ball.
Andrew Stevenson.
The 3-1 pitch.
One of my favorite pitches in the game right there. The old Greg Maddux equalizer. Started at the front hip and bring it back.
This is line to left. That's in there. Base hit. And the runner from third crosses the plate. Now a good throw comes into the infield, so that'll force the second runner to hold on over at third base. Joe Smith answers the call from dugout as he'll try to record the final two outs of this one. At the plate, Adrian Sanchez hit the other way out toward right field. On the move is Reddick, but he can't get to it, and this might clear the bases. And the second run will score as well.
The left fielder, number three, Michael A. Taylor.
In now, Michael Taylor. Popped up. Maldonado over to his left, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Settling in now, Eric Thames. Two hits in four attempts to this point. Second and third, two away. And a slider just about gets away from him there as it runs in a bit too close for comfort. And there's a called strike two, as now they're down to their final strike this afternoon. Last strike now for the Nats. Hit hard back up the middle. Throw on to first, and the ball game is over.
Well, this game had its moments, but it got out of hand pretty quick. Always nice when you can coast to a six-run win. Save your closer for another day and let everyone in on the action.
11-5, the final tally in this one. The Houston Astros posted a three-run first to propel them to the win. Jose Urquidy gets the W on the mound, Patrick Corbin couldn't escape the fourth inning as he slapped with the loss. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.